Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and this week there has been, well, less information than before since iOS 13.5 came out, so I wanted to cover a few different things ranging from iOS 13.5 to some features to expect with iOS 14 and a new app I found that I think you'll like. Now, the first thing is there's an app bug with iOS 13.5 that many have seen. Now, I covered this in my iOS 13.5 follow-up. And what I mean by that is maybe you're trying to open an app and it would not allow you to open the app. So instead of opening the app, you'd go into it and it would usually have to be a downloaded app. But once you try and open it, it wouldn't let you do that, and it would give you an error message. And this error message looks like this. It says the app is no longer shared with you. To use it, you must buy it from the App Store. Now, the people that were having this could just uninstall and reinstall the app, and it doesn't look like it's an issue with iOS 13.5, but rather something on the Apple server side, because they issued a ton of updates. So if you go into the App Store and then go to your profile, you'll probably have a ton of updates from days ago. So you'll see there's a few here where you've got May 21st and May 20th, and it will update them. I've gotten about 30 different updates. And so it looks like Apple's pushing those updates to fix that issue on multiple devices. And so whatever happened with that, thankfully they don't need a whole new iOS update for that, but it seems like it's on the server side and they're just pushing updates. No one has confirmed this at this point, but it seems like that's the fix for it. And that's why we're seeing all of those updates. Now, to go along with apps, there's this really interesting new app called Usage. If you haven't seen this, it actually shows you a lot of different information about your phone. So I know a lot of you like all these statistics. It's showing me my CPU usage, my memory usage, my storage usage, data usage. And it's also showing network activity, battery. It's showing if low power mode is on or off, if it's charging, and also gives more information about when the last time the phone was actually rebooted. So you'll see 6 days, 21 hours and 12 minutes ago, and it's got a lot more information in there as well. So there's a bunch of things in here. It's a free app and it's not an advertisement or anything. I just really like this app. It's a free app and also has a widget as well, but it does use some battery life when it's running. So just keep that in mind. So if you look at my battery life here, we'll go to battery, wait for it to load, you'll see that it's actually using 12% of my battery life. So that's probably because I have the widget installed. So if you're really concerned about that, just uninstall the widget, make sure it's not running in the background, and then go into it and take a look at it. But I think it's a really interesting app. I'll link it in the description if you want to try it out. And it's just a nice way to see all of this information. So there's a free and a paid version with more information, but I just thought it was really neat. Now, with the release of the next iPhone, the iPhone 12 or whatever they're going to call it, it looks like Apple may not include EarPods within the box. Now, I don't know how many people actually use EarPods and instead buy AirPods like these, but instead it seems like they may not include them. I think they should include them, and I don't think they'll ever include AirPods, but I think they should at least include headphones that go to the Lightning jack. But if they took that out, it would be similar to what you get with an iPad. You've got a wall adapter with a Lightning cable and that's it. It wouldn't surprise me if Apple did that. Now, speaking of EarPods or AirPods, it looks like the next generation AirPods will have an ambient light sensor in them. So whatever that means and whatever it's used for, whether it be health related or something else, AirPods have a bunch of sensors on them. If you haven't seen that, there's sensors to let it know when it's in your ear or not. They could use an ambient light sensor, maybe some other sensors as well to check for heart rate. You could do that through this device, but it depends on what they decide to do. So right now I would think they'll just put in another sensor, maybe for ambient light, maybe that ties to something else. It's hard to say, but it could be a health related feature for those that jog with their AirPods and things like that. It looks like we may have that. Also, those over the ear headphones that it looks like Apple's working on, many people are calling AirPod Studios. It looks like they've actually started production in the factory and may be available to be shown at WWDC in less than a month. So that's where we'll see things like iOS 14 and maybe some new products and things, maybe a new iMac, but there's no information about that iMac yet. Now, along with those AirPod Studio, it looks like we're going to have some new Powerbeats Pro very soon in four new colors. This was leaked by a website, and I'll link all the references in the description like I always do, but there's four different colors: Glacier Blue, Cloud Pink, Spring Yellow, and Lava Red. So if you're using Powerbeats Pro, it's actually something I use quite a bit. Here's my Powerbeats Pro. These are just the black one, but they could have this new color variant soon. And these are really nice if you want to use them for bass or editing or whatever you're doing with them. They're pretty nice headphones, at least for heavy bass. If you don't like heavy bass and you want accuracy, well, I wouldn't recommend Beats anyway, but they're nice to have on the go and they stay in my ears well. Now, before we talk about some features with iOS 14, it looks like the iPhone 12 logic board leaked. There was some leaks over in China, it looks like, where the logic board itself, that's the actual chipset and the board that's inside the iPhone, leaked on Twitter. Whether or not this is accurate, it's hard to say, but it seems pretty accurate since the factories are already manufacturing things and have prototypes and things like that. And you can't really tell a whole lot from the board itself. So basically you can expect a new CPU and A14 on it, and maybe some different RAM options and things like that. There's not a whole lot you can tell from it, but it looks like this might be what's inside the next iPhone. Now with iOS 14, that's what I'm looking most forward to. And we should see that on June 22nd at the Worldwide Developer Conference. So if you go to developer.apple.com, you can see it says on June 22nd, WWDC 20 takes off and it will be all online. So you should be able to view different sessions online. Now I would expect iOS 14 beta 1 on June 22nd. If Apple keeps doing the same sort of pattern they have for years, of course that could change, but that's usually what we can expect. And with iOS 14, there has not been a ton of information that's leaked out. So it looks like it's probably going to be more stability focused, but also there's evidence of things like AirTags in the code from people that actually have it. It looks like there's also a new AR app, like I've talked about before, which allows for the camera to pick up augmented reality things. And that makes sense if Apple is going to be working on AR glasses, which I'll talk about in a moment. There's also wallpaper organization I've talked about before. So instead of just having your wallpaper kind of like it is now, wherever it is, there we go. And instead of just choosing wallpaper, you'll be able to fully organize it and put it into categories. And I know a lot of you love the wallpapers, of course, so it'll be easier to organize them and share them later on. And then iMessage updates for things like retracting messages. And I've talked about that before, but it would be really nice to be able to send a message and then retract that message, similar to what you could do in Telegram with a message that you've sent. You can delete it for yourself and for the person you sent it to. So that gives some added privacy. Now, also there has been a lot of leaked information about Apple Glass. And so a lot of that John Prosser information going back and forth with Mark Gurman about this information. And it looks like Apple is definitely working on AR glasses, but John Prosser has said that they will come with subscription lenses. If you want those, you can add that to the price, which should be about $500. It'll have a display in both lenses and may be available in 2021 or maybe shown in 2021 and then available later in the year. It's hard to say with timelines that could all change, but it looks like Apple's definitely working on them and I'm pretty excited to see what they're like. I've used Google Glass and that was sort of like wearing an Android phone on your head. It was kind of convenient, but sort of goofy looking. And if Apple makes it, it could be stylish and something that you want to use regularly. So I look forward to that. I'm not sure what I would use it for other than maps and maybe some other things, but generally when Apple does something, they wait to make sure they have a good use case for it and then they do it right. So I'm looking forward to that and who knows what we'll see, when we'll see it, but it seems like it's definitely in the works. And so that's it for this week. There is not a whole lot of other things coming out. I wouldn't expect an iOS 13.5.1, but you never know depending on what happens with Apple with this update, if there's security issues and things like that. But again, in a couple weeks, we'll have iOS 14 to at least see what it's about and see what we've got as far as new features and hopefully a lot more stability. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.